President Trump, meanwhile, giving Congress 3 weeks to work on a border deal that will end the shutdown for good, he says. A group of bipartisan lawmakers, including our next guest, forming a Homeland Security Conference Committee to put together a border security package. That's the goal anyway. But will Democrats and Republicans act in good faith to make sure it includes funding for the wall? Let's ask one of those Democrats. He's Congressman David Price. He joins us live right now for an inside look. Good morning, Congressman. We appreciate you coming in.
Good morning. Thank you.
Let's understand how you're approaching. There's a lot of skepticism, as you can imagine, that Democrats want to negotiate in good faith. Do you believe that a border wall is immoral?
I believe that we need a multifaceted approach to border security, mm-hmm. and that in the past we've had various components to that. I think our goal right now is to keep government open and to make sure that all these 7 appropriations bills, including the one that I helped put together as transportation and housing ranking member, now chairman, that that those bills are enacted and we have our government up and running at full strength for the rest of the year.
But when you say multifaceted approach to border security, Democrats, I understand you talk about drones, which Republicans have talked about as well, other facets. But I want to ask you specifically, yes or no, does the multifaceted approach, according to you, one of the key members here, include a barrier or a wall?
I believe that the president, the key mistake the president made was in shutting the government down. You know, he can argue for whatever kind of physical barrier he wants to argue for, and I think we will insist that border security is about a lot more than physical barriers, and for that matter, Homeland Security is about a lot more than border security.
I get that, and I'm acknowledging that point, Congressman, but pardon me, you didn't answer both of my questions. The first one I said, is the wall immoral, yes or no?
If you're wanting me to anticipate the results of these negotiations, I'm not going to do that.
I'm trying to ask you, I'm trying to get a foundation. Is the border wall, as Nancy Pelosi said, she said it's immoral. Do you agree with her?
I tell you what I think, she can speak for herself, but I tell you what I think she meant. I think she meant that in this present context, there is a range of immigration policies that are so outrageous, so egregious on the part of President Trump and his administration.
Okay.
Those policies are immoral. It's immoral to separate families at the border. It's immoral to have these raids, indiscriminate raids, and deport people willy-nilly.
I get it. I've heard all that before, and I've heard those attacks.
It's immoral to stop refugee flows from the world's most desperate countries.
But, Congressman, we're not talking about border security. Let's talk about border security, please.
I'm talking about the wall having become a symbol of a range of policies that are absolutely reprehensible.
So let me try one more specific. I get all the attacks on the president.
This becomes a very fraught discussion.
Okay, fraught discussion. Let's be specific. I asked you whether it was immoral. I didn't get an answer. I asked you whether border security includes a wall or barrier. You did not answer directly. Let me ask a third specific question. Does your talk about multifaceted approach to border security, how much money are you willing to give for a barrier? The speaker said $1. How much are you willing to give?
I'm telling you, we're going to have a serious negotiation about what border security looks like and needs to be. And there are many, many areas of agreement. I think we need to fortify our ports of entry. That's where the drugs are coming in. That's where we need better detection, more personnel.
Sure.
I think we can agree on that.
Okay, but again,
I think,
does it include a barrier, yes or no? I mean, I'm giving you a chance. You launched all your attacks on the president about family separation. You're talking about a multifaceted approach. Does a multifaceted approach, according to Democrats, you're one of the leaders, include a barrier, yes or no?
You tell me, I won't tell you how to ask the question if you don't tell me how to answer it.
I'm not telling you how to answer it. I'm asking a specific question, sir. I'm giving you a chance to answer multiple times, and I'm going to let our audience and everyone else decide.
I was the chairman of Homeland.
Does it include a barrier?
I was the chairman of Homeland Security. I was the chairman of the Homeland Security Appropriations Committee when we built almost 700 miles of fence.
Okay.
You know that. And we didn't just build it. We subjected it to scrutiny as to whether this is the best way to achieve border security, as to what it would do to surrounding communities and land and ranches and so on.
So you get credit for that, sir, on a bipartisan basis, you're telling me, and you're right, that in previous years, Democrats and Republicans came together and said there needs to be a barrier. There needs to be fencing on that 700 miles, but not all of it was funded. So my question now, which is relevant to these current discussions, you get credit for previously wanting a barrier. Do you still want a new barrier? Do you still support a barrier?
I think there are many, many priorities that are much more pressing than a physical barrier. Moreover, I think the president has poisoned the well here. He's made this ridiculous demand for a concrete wall, a symbol of his presidency, and he's gone after immigrants in a way that he shouldn't be surprised if this becomes a very toxic debate just about a physical barrier.
And you've pushed back on it many times. One last time, do you support a barrier? Yes or no?
I'm not going to anticipate the result of these negotiations.
All right. We'll let everyone decide. You can let us know. Friends at FoxNews.com. Congressman David Price, I greatly appreciate you coming in and answering the questions. Thank you.
Sure thing.
All right.